Welcome to Top Shelf Men. I'm Reese. Today we're going to be discussing the I love to travel red flag. So I live in a large metropolitan city and I have short-term dated my fair share of female tourists. Now they were all girls that later informed me that they were in committed relationships and they love to travel. Women generally lack self-awareness, but they love attention, so they tend to talk too much about themselves and they give a lot of things away if you listen closely. Now, they can't help to mention that they've been to over 20 countries and they love to travel because they want to sound interesting. They want to sound like they are worldly, and people generally take these things at face value. Young people have been brainwashed to believe the blank slate theory. So pretty much men and women are exactly the same. They're just taught differently and that's why they're different, which is, you know, if you are red pill aware, you know it's total bullshit. And it couldn't be further from the truth. Men and women's brains are wired differently. Now, when receiving this information from a girl, oh, I've been to 20, 30 countries, your average blue pill chump is gonna think, wow, she's so interesting because she's world traveled, she's worldly. But if you're red pill aware, you're gonna think, so how many foreign guys did you bang on each trip? You know, like, I better be careful with this one because, you know, if I bang her, I better wear a condom. Anyone that has traveled with a woman knows that women always value safety and comfort. Now, you can tell this because they always overpack and they bring a lot of useless things they will never need, but hey, they don't want to be without them. Now, this is because safety and comfort is top priority to the way women's brains are wired, because they are the vulnerable sex. And reality is that safe and comfortable is boring. Now, men know you don't find adventure through predictable and catered experiences. Women, on the other hand, they love those kinds of things. They will do all the touristy stuff. For example, they go to cafes, museums, and shopping. And eventually, they will have done that enough times in a few countries that they'll start to get bored with themselves, because safe and comfortable is boring. Now, think back to the women you have dated in the past and think about the amount of times that they genuinely suggested something cool to do or they had an idea of where to go or what to eat. I mean, the reality is women in general, with few exceptions, they're pretty terrible at thinking of fun things to do. Now, their solo travel will make them bored and a bit lonely since there's no guy around to shower them with attention. And then they realize something, and that something is that, well, they're in a foreign place, nobody knows them, they can do whatever they want, and they can simply trade their sexuality for a little excitement. A 20-something-year-old woman working a corporate slave job is usually traveling overseas once or twice a year. Now, each trip starts to become less memorable. They get lonely from not having their boyfriend, fiance, husband, or orbiting betas around. Then, they are not getting the attention they're used to back home. So, they decide to start making each trip a little more memorable by banging a hot and exciting new guy on each trip. Now, as Rolo Tomasi says, they want to bang the hot guy at the foam cannon party during their party years. And another thing these I love to travel girls start to quickly realize is that overseas they have an increased sexual market value. Now, while they are overseas, they're going to be seen as more exotic by the locals. And being a tourist opens up availability for other men that normally would be out of their league, for the reason being is that they're only going to be around for a week. The guy realizes this, and it's like, well, she's going to be gone in a week anyway. Now, you know, the hot guy doesn't have to worry about this girl sticking around, causing drama, calling him at odd hours because he's not really into her, but she's available, and why not? And at the end, she's going to be gone in a week or two anyway, so there's no drama to worry about. Deep down inside, these women know it's a temporary fling, and that's why they're perfectly fine being used by that hot foreign guy that is absolutely out of their league and they know that realistically, if they were local, they wouldn't be able to lock down a guy that attractive. The one exception to the girls that, you know, love to travel and they've been to a handful of countries are the girls that have always vacationed with their parents. I've met a couple of these. And when they're with their parents, yes, they do have a temptation, you know, by the attractive exotic guys. But the reality is that women don't like to be judged, particularly by their parents. So they will, you know, keep themselves in check. And generally, when it's a family vacation, they're not going to sneak off into the night and disappear and then come back the next morning. In general, if their parents are not a mess and, you know, usually their parents are together, it's very, very PG-13 for these family vacations. That's the one exception I have found. You can also tell when your long-term relationship is on borrowed time. I've talked to a lot of men about this, and there comes a time in a relationship when things are dying down. Slowly, they're kind of repelling each other. They're not, you know, the sex is not as frequent. There's really, you know, they're just together because they moved in together and they're already stuck with each other. And this is when a guy's girlfriend or wife says, oh, I'm going to take a trip with my friends, or I'm going to take a solo trip to Cancun, or I'm going to go to Canada, or anything of any sort of nature where they're going to do solo trips, or Vegas. And the reality is that at that point, they're looking to monkey branch. They're looking to find themselves on top of the next guy so that when they come back from their vacation, it's going to be easier for them to break up. Because women, in general, they always have a plan. They always have an exit strategy. That's why they say, cats always land on their feet and women always land on their backs. In conclusion, the problem with the I love to travel girls is that they've been passed around. And they've been very highly likely been alpha widowed by some exotic Chad somewhere that was already way out of their league. Now, the problem with this is, well, now her ability to pair bond with you is severely damaged. Now, you can see her as a plate or a friend with benefits, but never consider these kinds of girls for a long-term serious relationship. And you have to remember, no matter how beautiful she is, no matter how interesting she seems, no matter how kind she may be, these women, they damage themselves. It's not your responsibility to save them from, oh, I wanted to visit 30 countries and feel special in each one by a different guy. You know, don't be a Captain Save-A-Ho. Thank you for watching to the end of this video. Again, I'm Reese. If you enjoyed this content, please like and subscribe for more Red Pill content, forging top shelf men. Until next video, peace.